म्यूकोमाइकोसिस ब्लैक फंगल आई इन्फेक्शन. आई गॉट लॉट ऑफ मेल्स फ्रॉम यू ऑल, लॉट ऑफ फोन कॉल्स, सो मेनी कमेंट्स. एवरीबडी वॉन्टेड मी टू स्पीक ऑन म्यूकोमाइकोसिस. सो आई एम हियर विथ यू डॉक्टर सुमित्रा टू टॉक अबाउट द फंगल आई इन्फेक्शन. लेट मी टेल यू, डोंट गेट सो स्केयर्ड अबाउट इट. It's the duty of the social media, your WhatsApp, your Facebook and other social media group to expand a thing and talk to you in such a way that you get scared about it. There's nothing to get scared. Yes, you need to worry and act correctly at the right time. That is important. So today I'm going to take up your questions and reply to them. I'll try to give the answers to as many questions as possible today. If not, rest I will address tomorrow. So now let me start with it. So let me start from the very basic question. What is mucormycosis? I'm sure you all have gone through internet, gone through Google, and got a lot of answers about it. Now let me tell you from my point. Mucormycosis is a fungal disease. And let me tell you, my dear friends, it was prevalent since long. It's not a new disease. It's not the one which has now developed. When we were studying medical, we have read about this as a rare disease, rare fungal infection. That's why you don't get to know a lot about it in the past. But it was very much prevalent. Now what happens in case of COVID patients? If they had COVID infection and they got recovered from COVID-19, then there are a lot of people who are getting infected by fungal infection. And this fungal infection is mucormycosis. So I think I'm very clear with the first question. What is mucormycosis? Also, I'm clearing you that this was prevalent before also. Why with COVID patients? I'll come to this question. Before that, I would like to tell you about some of the symptoms. Before coming to it, let's take a deep breath. You also take. Now tell me what actually happened. You inhaled the air inside, right? So this air reached your lungs. Okay. Also, it reached to some other places. In our face, we have four pair of sinuses. Two here, two here, two here, two deeper. So what are these four sinuses? Sinuses means spaces. Maxillary sinus, frontal sinus, ethmoid sinus, and sphenoid sinus. Again, take a long breath. So this air went to the lungs and also some air got trapped in the sinuses. Now let me tell you, this air that you inhaled does have bacteria, does have virus, and also does have fungus, pollutants, irritants, and whatnot, everything from the environment. Every moment it is entering your body. This is where your immunity works. It fights back. It kills the unwanted bacteria, virus, fungus, and other things that are entering into your body and can harm your body. This is the defense mechanism of our body. Lot of it is done by macrophagic activity. This is a foreign body. It is engulfed by the macrophages and killed. Again, I'm deep breathing. Again, lot of germs are going. But they are not being able to produce any kind of mucormycosis in me. or any kind of fungal infection. So now my question is, why now? Isn't it? Yes, you have to understand why now. And now also post-COVID patients, why? Why post-COVID patient? Let's talk about it. In case of COVID infection, your body system is getting defeated. Your body is becoming vulnerable. Your body's immunity is getting low and lower. Your body's defense mechanism to fight against these microbes is reducing. Things are going inside. Now the body mechanism which should fight against it is falling weak. The fungus entered, the fungal spores entered, and it found a picnic garden. And it started proliferating. And you are into a problem. Have you ever seen a sponge? Put some water and put that sponge on it. The sponge is going to absorb the water, isn't it? Our lung alveoli. It is also like sponge. The moment we breathe in, this air contains some moisture. This moisture, once it reaches our alveoli, the alveoli absorbs the moisture and it becomes wet. Before continuing further, I want to tell you, when we were small in our school days, we have been taught about an experiment that take a bread, put some water into it, keep it outside. After some days, fungus will grow on it, isn't it? Even if you have not done this experiment, you must have experienced it in your real life. That if you keep a bread for some time, open exposed air, it is getting oxygen, it is getting the air, it is also getting the moisture, and fungus will grow. So for a fungus to grow, some facilitating things are there. So what are the air and moisture? These two things are very important. So now again, deep breathing. This fungal spores which entered your body reached your lung alveoli, the spongy alveoli, which is already wet, getting oxygen and air inside. What will this fungal spore do now? It will rest there in peace. Okay. R.I.P. RIP. This will come to you later. But the fungus will rest in peace inside your lung alveoli. And you know what's next? It is getting favorable environment to proliferate, and it will start proliferating. And there where the problem lies. Now, next thing. When I deep breathe inside, this air is not only reaching our sinuses, not only reaching our lungs, but from the back, it has an access to the brain also. Why did I tell this? I'm going to explain it a little later. So it can reach your brain also. So now coming back to the symptoms of this fungal infection. Fever is there. See, now the list of symptoms that I am going to tell you, you might not have all the symptoms. But all the symptoms are very significant and you must notice it if it is present in you. You can have black patches around. That black patches may start growing. Right? You might have a headache. Sudden onset of headache. You might have a pain in your cheek area. You might have a toothache. You might feel that your gums are getting loosened and the teeth is thereby shaking. Your teeth is also about to fall down. The tooth is loose. So, now you have to understand. At times, sometimes you will also find out that from your nose some blood is coming out. From your mouth, the blood vomiting is coming out. You might have blur vision. You might have double vision. You might have gastric trouble. You are not having proper digestion. And there's a very high possibility, one of the most alarming symptoms, if this has entered to your brain, you are going to have problem with your mind. You are going to start telling irrelevant things, a sort of delirium. You must have noticed people who are into a very high fever, they start talking absurd. Similar kind of absurd talk happens in this case. The person starts talking irrelevant, start replying irrelevant, and he's into a confused state of mind. Let me tell you, my friends, if this is the case, you have to immediately contact your doctor. You can't leave this. You have a headache. You think that, okay, it's okay. I'm just going to take a painkiller and then I'm going to go for a sleep. It will subside. No, my dear friends. In this corona pandemic time, no symptom can be left or ignored. The point from where we started this whole session is, we at the end of the day don't want this fungal infection to infect our eye and take the eye away from us. We don't want enucleation. We don't want to get the eye removed. We don't want to fit a prosthetic eye. So in that case, your first and foremost intention should be to address every symptom that is coming to you. Your doctor can help you if you have reached the doctor at the correct point of time. Your doctor will not be able to help you if you reach him at a later point of time. Tell me, I am a doctor, and others also, your doctor is going to visit you or your family or friend. Do you think anybody would intend to enucleate your eye and permanently disfigure your face? No one. But it's so difficult for the doctor at the OT table to make a judgment or have a consent from you for enucleating your eye. He is also equally traumatized. He definitely does not intend to do it. But he is forced to do it when he has to compare it with your life. If there is an option that you are two-eyed and you are dying, and there is an option that I can keep one eye and you will be alive, tell me as a doctor what you would be doing. Certainly you would be enucleating the person. In this kind of fungal infection, suppose this area is developing the fungus, the black part is growing, the doctor has to remove the skin, has to operate this area. And let me tell you, he is going to also take some healthy skin also from outside, so that you are not going to have a progression of the fungus. These are the things which we have to understand. For a post-COVID case, let me tell you, I have been seeing so many people, hearing from so many people, I had COVID, I got treated, I was in the hospital for 14-15 days. Now when this patient is returning back to his house, he is having a false assumption, a false picturization in his mind, that now I have passed through this phase and now I'm not going to get again infected, nor I'm going to be a carrier. This person is now moving around everywhere without mask. He is not maintaining any corona protocols. These are the people who might have this infection. For all the post-COVID patients, let me tell you, you have to use mask. You have to keep cleaning your hand. You have to maintain social distancing for your benefit and also for the benefit of the people with whom you are. You have to take your medicines and keep your diabetes under control if you are diabetic. You have to take your cardiac medicines if you are under any cardiac treatment. You have to take hypertension medicines if you are under BP medications. You have to take nutritious diet to boost up your immunity. You have to take antioxidants. You have to frequently take electrolyte water. You have to keep your body hydrated. What are the other things that you can do? You can go for a routine check of your blood. You can go for this check for the main purpose is that once anything that is invading in our body, our defense mechanism is the blood. And in blood specifically WBC. In WBC, neutrophil. So when the blood picture is taken, your blood sample is taken, your routine examination of blood is done, it will be found that your neutrophil count has reduced. That's one of the alarming symptoms where you have to do immediate action. You can go for a chest x-ray. You can go for your sputum analysis. You can also go for your nasal swab analysis. These are the things that are needed. But let me tell you, my friends, you have given your sample for testing. The report is not going to come immediately. It is going to take some time. And in this time, you have to maintain everything that is maintained and told you by the guidelines. ICMR has given lot of guidelines. WHO has given lot of guidelines. AYUSH has given lot of guidelines. Follow all these guidelines. I have already briefed the guidelines. I will again further brief it in this session. So now, let me tell you one thing. The people who are having COVID infection and who have been treated and are right now in healthy condition, 2 to 3 months you have to take care and do all the precautions. You have to keep monitoring your skin and look for any black patches developing or not. It is very important for you to do this. Every day you have to check your vitals. Vitals in the sense you have to take your temperature. The normal temperature should be 98.4. Second, everybody is having a pulse oximeter. You have to take your oxygen. It should not be below 95. Right? Apart from this, when I am telling you that you have to wear a mask, let me explain you about a mask a bit. Because lot of us have lot of misconceptions about a mask. See, today I am going to talk to you about mask also. There are lot of misconceptions, lot of notions about a mask. Remember, friends, initially when this coronavirus infection spread just a year back, we were talking about N95 mask, isn't it? But are we talking about it at this present moment? No, we are not. Why? Let me tell you. At present, we are talking about something other than this. We are going to talk about some other mask that we are going to use. Let me tell you, you are going to use 2 masks at all times. I want to explain you about the mask. First, you must have seen, heard, and also talked about a mask which is triple ply mask. 3-layered mask. Isn't it? By now I am sure everybody knows a lot of things about mask. Isn't it? So the 3-ply mask, that's a triple layer mask. What is the best property of this mask? It is waterproof. So that is the first mask that you are going to put. What did I tell? Triple ply mask, that is the first mask, which is the waterproof mask, you are going to first wear it. On top of this mask, you are going to wear one more mask which is made of cotton. You can make it yourself at your house or you can procure it from the market. So this is how you are going to wear 2 masks at all times. In any case, this mask, if it gets wet, your outer mask, your inner mask is waterproof. So you are not going to get infected. Things that I want to talk to you about mask. What happens when we wear a mask? There are times when we feel some irritation in our nose area and from above the mask we do like this. Isn't it? We do. Or we hold the mask and rub our nose. Right? Now I want to drink water. What will I do? I will pull the mask down and drink water. Right? The mask cord is loose. It is slipping down from my nose repeatedly. Most of the time it is here. Right? Let me tell you, my friends, all are wrong. You cannot do either of them. So the first thing is, when you are wearing a mask, you have to keep in mind few steps. The mask should cover your nose, your mouth, including your chin area. First thing, what happens if I am not wearing a mask? See, when I am trying to talk to you, as a person, you are standing in front of me and I am trying to talk to you, you will see there are times when you will be able to see some perceptible droplets coming out of my mouth. Same happens when you are talking. Some droplets, visible droplets, I can see, whereas lot of invisible droplets come out from our mouth when we are talking. So if I am an infected person, I am going to pass this infection to you. And if you are infected, you are going to pass the infection to me. There is one more important thing. If I am standing far apart from you, this droplet is unable to reach me. And your droplet is also not reaching. Why repeatedly we are talking about social distancing? The reason is this only: to avoid the spread of infection from your body to the person's body through your mouth and nose. Now, if you are wearing a mask, first there is a disposable mask, 3-ply mask, which is waterproof. And on that there is a cotton mask. You will notice that there are lot of times when you feel some discomfort in your nose area or some irritation, and you tend to do like this. We do this quite often. And this has increased in the present scenario. You notice yourself, notice the people around you. This access to your face area has increased because all the irritants are continuously irritating you, and you tend to scrub your face, scrub your nose, and that is very natural. So what you have to do, you cannot touch your face area without keeping your hands clean. So first thing, you have to wash your hands properly, you have to sanitize your hand. And then only you can put your hand on your face or nose area. Right now, when I did talk to you about this droplets, I want to add one more thing here. Suppose I am an infected person and the droplet from me has gone in front, and say, suppose I am in a mall and it has reached the handle of the escalator. Okay. This droplet infection, which has spread from my mouth, nose to the escalator handle, it is going to survive there for 3 consecutive days. And it is potential and capable of creating infection to any other person who is coming in contact with it. So think. If you are not maintaining the hygiene, if you are not keeping your hands clean, and if from your hand the contamination goes to your face or mouth, you are definitely going to get infected. What do you think? Why so many people got infected? You have to be very conscious. You have to follow the corona protocols. Now, one more thing. Suppose I am wearing a mask. There are a lot of people whose mask keeps sliding down and they keep pulling the mask up, right? How do they pull the mask up? They put this finger, one finger inside, one outside, and they pull the mask up. So now suppose I am going to a market and I am in a market. My mask is loose, it is falling down. What will I do? I have to pull the mask up. How will I pull the mask up? The easiest way what people do is hold the mask like this and then pull it up. Right? this finger was exposed to external air. Maybe there is a high possibility I have touched some or the other object. So this area got infected, and the moment I do it like this, I am putting this infection inside. Now I am breathing. This infection is going inside my body. I am thirsty. I want to drink water. What will I do? I'll slide the mask down to my neck area. I drink water, I slide it back. This area was exposed to atmosphere. This was not sterilized. This was not cleaned. No sanitization. And pulling it up to your nose, thereby infecting my own self. What can I do now? I have a very good option. I want to drink water. Open this mask, let it hang like this, drink water, close it again. Instead of scrubbing it on your neck. If the mask is loose, tighten it. Don't wear a loose mask which is either staying here, keeping pulling it again and again. The more you handle your face, the more you are exposed to infection. What I have seen in when I go out or I observe people coming to my place, the worst thing that happens is after wearing a mask, the person is handling his face more often than what he was doing before, thereby spreading infection to himself, to all the people who is in his surrounding. So this is something that you have to learn to avoid. You cannot infect yourself, and you have no right to infect the people who are in your surrounding. It is as simple as that. See, one important thing you have to understand. There was a protocol given to people to maintain social distancing, wear mask, keep your body clean, keep your hands clean, keep your surrounding clean, use sanitizers. Ask yourself, how religiously have you done it? What we are facing today is because of our own mistakes. And if we don't control it at this point, we are again going to get exposed to further problems. And then every one of us keep on asking, when will Corona go away? What is my role? What is my effort? Does matter in this case. In this Corona time, lot of people who are staying back at home, you know, what are they doing to keep themselves busy? Many of us have opted for gardening. Right or wrong? Yes. Gardening is not a problem. But if you have to maintain the Corona protocol there also. How? Let me tell you this fungus about which we are talking at this point of time. It prevailed all throughout in the past. Today it is potential enough to kill a man. Why it was not that potential in the past? Our body's immunity was able to fight back with it. But at this point it is not being able to fight back. Because we are already exposed to COVID. This COVID is already reducing our immunity. We have already become vulnerable to get diseases. And that's why our body is unable to fight back, and the virus, the fungus, everything is putting us into a lot of problem and also taking away of our lives. So the people who want to do gardening, let me tell you, this fungus is also present in the soil. So once you are handling the soil, planting, you are changing the pots, this soil is getting inside your body. And with this soil, the fungus is also going inside your body, and you can have n number of complications. So to avoid any kind of complications, if you want to do gardening, you are most welcome to do it. But wear double mask, gloves, full sleeves cloth, full covered shoes. Once you are done with your gardening thing, come, change the entire dress, bath, clean yourself, sanitize your hand with the alcohol-based sanitizer. then only do any other thing that you want to do. With COVID patient, I'm telling you, this fungus is being very detrimental just because the person has already been into a critical crisis of immunity. He was not able to fight back his situation. And in that case, he is getting one more disease. The people who are diabetic, the people who have heart disorders, the people who are hypertensive, you have to keep a control of everything. You have to be under your physician who is taking care of these things. And you have to be telecalling them and getting yourself managed. Any person who is taking immunocompromised drugs, any person steroids, any person who has any transplantation in the body, for that they are under some medications. All these people are very vulnerable to catch this mucormycosis. I have received a very beautiful question from one of you, my friends, and I'm willing to talk to you about it. There was a case who is talking to me and telling that two people in my house were COVID positive and under home isolation they got treated. And two of my relatives, they also had COVID infection and they were in such a state that they were admitted in the hospital and afterwards they developed this fungal infection. So how do I take it as a third person? Very beautiful question. Let me tell you one thing. The two people who were in isolation at house and got treated, you must agree with me that these two people were not as critical as the ones who were admitted. So already the probability of their getting treated faster without complication was higher, because they did not reach to the extent where the two others reached. They were rushed to the hospital. So this already had a better prognosis. And now these two people who went to the hospital, get the information from them, they were oxygenated or not? Yes, they were. I have to tell you one thing, that when any oxygen is given to a person, only oxygen is not given. With this, some humidity is also given. Humidity in the sense, some water. How will this water go to the body with the oxygen? By the help of humidifier. Humidifier will convert this water and with mixed with the oxygen, it will go to your body, to your lungs. Now think, how is that possible? So there is definitely a source of water which is getting converted by the humidifier, right? If this water is an old water, if this water is not clear, clean, proper water, not sterilized water, it is infected water, it has fungal spores, will these spores not enter your body? Yes, definitely this will enter your body. And once you inhale, it is going to your lungs, it is going to your sinuses, it is going to your brain. Every day on a routine basis, bacteria, virus, fungus, everything is entering our body, but our body is able to fight back the macrophage action. Everything is happening inside the body, which is called immunity, fighting back the white blood cells, are defeating them and making us sustain the life. In post-COVID patient, this complication, which was once called a rare fungal infection, has cropped up like anything, just because our body was not being able to push it back from the body. In my routine practice of prosthetic eye, I have seen a lot of patients who had some fungal infection in the eye and the eye was removed, or the eye turned white, it became later on turned thysical. And these patients, I have fitted, hundreds of patients I have fitted with prosthetic eye. How this person got this fungal infection, do you know? Suppose he is cycling or he is going on bike or he is walking on the road and there was a huge thunderstorm. All the dust, all the soil started flowing in the air. Some of it entered his eye. And his eye got exposed to fungal infection. Mismanaged case led to hypopyon, corneal scarring and whatnot, and the eyesight was lost. So fungal eye infection was not only today, it was also in the past. There were many cases which, if addressed at the right time, were able to get cured. And there are a lot of patients who are not being able to get cured because of not coming to the doctor at the right time. And same is the scenario today. The moment you have slight headache, the moment you have pain in your cheek, the moment you have pain in your teeth, the moment suddenly your teeth started, you know, getting loose, the moment the blood is coming out from your nose, the blood is coming out from your mouth, the moment you have gastric trouble, you have to speak to your doctor and get it addressed immediately. The moment you see there is, there are black spots growing in your face, it is expanding, address it immediately. One of the most, you know, diagnostic symptoms I can tell you which you can catch up is the person starts talking irrelevant. The moment the person starts talking irrelevant, you have to understand that the moment he has inhaled it, it has gone to his brain. His higher controls have lost. He is talking absurd. He is not talking relevant. You are talking something else, he is talking something else. Immediately this patient needs to be addressed. It will not give you time. It will not give you a day's time. It will not give you a hour's time. You have to act immediately. You start seeing double, you start seeing blur. You have to address it immediately. Let me tell you, these are the common symptoms which are present in the day-to-day life. I have eaten ice cream, my toothache is happening. Don't take it that easily. I did not sleep at night properly, so I am having headache. No, you cannot take it that simply. It could be a simple headache, but you have to get it ruled out. On your part, you can get your swab tested. You can get your nose discharge tested. You can get your x-ray done. You can get yourself blood picture can be taken. So your blood is taken, routine examination of your blood. If the neutrophil count is very less, you need immediate attention. That means your body, your WBC, your white blood cells, your neutrophils, your defense mechanism, nothing is being able to combat the situation. You have to act immediately. Let me tell you, as a doctor, none of us want you to die. Our first intention, first motive is that you should be safe, secure and fine at your house. I'm sure most of us have lost our near and dear ones in this COVID. In last 1 year, we have seen the deaths of parents, we have seen the deaths of grandparents, we have seen the deaths of brothers, sisters, children and whatnot. Our friends, our associates, we have lost a lot of lives. And we definitely don't want to lose it any further. If you are having any of these symptoms, talk to your doctor immediately. Address it, get it solved. And let me tell you, if your body is not stable, if your body's immunity is low, if you are in an immunocompromised state, if your diabetes is uncontrolled, if your heart problem is uncontrolled, if your hypertension is not controlled, you are definitely going to be into some bigger problem. So you have to maintain all these things. Every day morning, once you get up, check your temperature. The normal temperature should be 98.4. If it is 98.4, then it's fine. The moment it is crossing it, you have to think, work. Now if I talk about oxygen, check your oxygen. I hope everybody is having pulse oximeter at the house. So you need to check your oxygen. If your oxygen is coming below 95, you have to get it checked. You have to contact your doctor. You have to get it addressed. You have to find out why it is happening so. Further, I want to add to this. If you are a post-COVID patient, what are the things you should do? Take a note of what are the points that I am going to tell you at this point of time. I just told you that you have to monitor your vitals. If you are diabetic, you have to control your diabetes. You have to keep monitoring whether you are under control or not. And to everybody who is listening to me right now, you will be alarmed to know that many of us are diabetic, but we don't know because we have never gone for any routine checkup. So everyone who is listening to this video at this point of time, I am telling you that go for a routine examination of your diabetes, blood sugar level, and see whether your sugar is under control or not. So you have to do two tests for blood sugar. One is early morning, which is called fasting sugar, and second after 2 hours of your eating. So these two blood sugar tests you have to do it. After your blood sugar test, you can also go in for your routine examination of blood to find out what is the status of your WBC, white blood cells, especially neutrophils. So that you have to see and check whether there is neutropenia. Neutropenia means there is reduction in the neutrophil count. Third, that you have to do every day morning, check your temperature. I had already told you, check your temperature, check your oxygen. This is important. If you are under any immunosuppressive drugs, if you are under any steroids, if you are under cancer medications, if you are under chemotherapy, if you are having any body transplanted and you are under some medications for it, steroids, any of this, you have to keep it monitored and be under your proper guide. If you are having cardiac problem, if you are having high pressure, these things have to be addressed. Most important is you have to increase your immunity. To increase your immunity, what are the things you can do? You can eat healthy food, you can have nutritious diet, you can have antioxidants, you can hydrate your body by taking electrolyte water. These are the basic things that you have to do. You have to keep your body clean, you have to keep your hand clean, as less as possible touch your face area, as less as possible move around. Wear double mask always. Try not to talk to people at close distance. Maintain a distance from people. For 2 to 3 months, you have to take extra care for yourself. One very good thing that you can do every morning is sit in sun. Sun has lot of potential. The sun can protect you from bacterial, viral, fungal, many kinds of infections. Say your body is exposed to some kind of infection. If you sit in the sun, these bacteria, virus, funguses will not get such favorable environment to grow inside. In that case, it is going to be of great help to you. So sitting in sun every day morning is a must. Avoid the places where humidity is high. What do I mean by this? You are not going to go to places which is high in humidity. That means, suppose there is a rainfall. So that means when there is a rainfall, the water content of this air is higher. And if I inhale it, the water content will go inside. And this water, since our lung is like a sponge, it is going to absorb it. Thereby, when I inhale any bacteria, virus, fungus, anything inside, it is going to get a favorable environment and grow. Right? So in that case, we have to avoid humid areas. Third thing what you can do is, you can avoid the place where there is air cooler. If you are in a habit of sitting in a room where there is air cooler, stop doing that. To keep a room cool, there are two methods. One is air conditioner, second is air cooler. You can sit in AC room, but avoid the room which has air cooler. That is one very important thing you can do. So my dear friends, with this, we have come to the end of today's session. Hope these informations are of some help to you. Tomorrow again, I will take up other questions sent by you. Stay safe. Stay happy. Have a great day. Thank you.